What's happening, guys? Today I want to talk about how to stop dieting, get your calories back up, and not gain any of the weight back, or at least minimize it. So one of the things that you have to understand, this is something I talk about frequently if you are a routine visitor of my channel, is how the metabolism, it becomes suppressed from dieting. The longer you diet, the more aggressively you diet, the more your metabolism slows down. There's literally no way around this. This is just part of the body's self-defense mechanism against starvation. So you diet long, you diet hard, metabolism slows down, hormones get out of whack. It becomes very easy to gain weight back once we go back to higher calories again. But there's some strategies we can take to try to at least minimize this process. And while yes, it can be very easy to overeat and to gain back weight pretty fast. In fact, a lot of times people will put it back on in a matter of just a few weeks after dieting for months because they get into a position where their metabolism gets really slow and they overeat like crazy because hormones are out of whack and they just feel like they can't take it anymore and they overshoot. Not only do we want to avoid this, but one of the things that is not talked about very frequently and something that is not well understood is after this dieting period, you're actually in a really good position to be able to get your calories up, probably even higher than they were before you even started the dieting phase, and not only keep from gaining the weight back, but maybe even lose a little bit more, or at least at a minimum, minimize the amount of gain that you're going to get from bringing the calories back up. See, when you've been dieting for a long time, these adaptations are happening with your metabolism, and a lot of things are happening. You're probably getting a little bit drained, right? It's fatiguing. You're probably a little bit overreached. You're probably not sleeping quite as well. You might be a little bit more anxious and a little bit more stressed out. All these things are natural occurrences to happen while dieting, but your recovery suffers because of this. So when you stop, if you come out of your diet with a proper reverse diet where you slowly increase your calories and don't do it too fast and stay meticulous, you are actually in a position where now your metabolism is going to start speeding back up again. You're going to start recovering better. You're going to start sleeping better. You're going to start utilizing the calories that you give to your body better. And it's kind of like this perfect environment to really allow your metabolism to start taking off. But this only happens if you stay meticulous to the plan. And this is where it gets difficult. See, most of the time what happens is people get done dieting and they're so over the whole dieting thing because they've been doing it for so long and it's gotten so difficult that they don't want to think about tracking macros anymore or paying attention. And plus, you just don't have that goal, you know, sit in front of you anymore. You're not thinking about trying to lose weight. You're not actively trying to burn more fat. So it becomes a little bit more difficult to stay focused on what you're doing because you don't quite have that goal, that laser focus that you had before, that reason to really stay diligent, but you actually do. And I'm telling you, I see it time and time again. When people are meticulous with their macros, coming out of a dieting phase, going through a reverse diet, which if you don't know what a reverse diet is, if you're new to my channel and you're finding this in a search, I have tons of videos about reverse dieting. I have approximately one crap load of videos on reverse dieting. I'll put a link to a playlist at the end of this video so you can check it out. But basically the process is you slowly increase your calories, slowly reduce your cardio so that you allow your metabolism to adapt to the changes without gaining a bunch of body fat back. And this way you can get your calories up, not have to just basically, if you want to maintain your weight, you don't have to stay in those low calories. You can get your calories back up and still roughly maintain and do it in a better position where you can actually, you know, enjoy life a little bit more. But what I find is when people are really meticulous coming out of a dieting phase and they still stick to their macros and they still take it just as seriously as they did during their dieting phase, the reverse process usually goes extremely well. You can usually ramp up calories pretty fast and you will still maintain, possibly even lose, as the metabolism really starts to crank along and you start to recover better and you start to perform better and you get more energy. So you move around more during the day and you kind of get a little bit more neat and you are able to just properly utilize everything better than you were before because your recovery is better and you're getting more food, you're getting more fuel, and the body is just functioning better now. But this only happens if you stay meticulous. So I find that in the beginning stages, you definitely want to utilize extra carbs as much as possible. Use more carbs. Increase your carbs over fats in the beginning stages. The body just likes it, it utilizes it better, it creates a more anabolic environment. It just seems to work. As your calories get higher, now you can start adding more fats in if you want, but in the beginning stages, I really strongly recommend going through carbs as much as possible in the beginning stages. So how fast should you increase your carbs? Well, it really just kind of depends on how things are going. So if it's going really well and you're actually losing, then you can increase your calories faster. If you're just kind of maintaining, you might want to take a more moderate approach, or if you're finding that you're gaining, then you're going to want to slow down the process a little bit. So typically I find somewhere between 10 and 15 grams of carbs per week is usually a pretty good point. Again, it just kind of depends on how things are going. If it's going really well, you can increase them faster. Maybe you can increase, you know, 20, 25 carbs. Or if it's not going very well, maybe you only go like 5 carbs, just kind of depending on where. There's so many ways to do this. There's no like bottom line, this is how you do it. But usually between like 40 and 80 calories, or 2% to 10% of your total calories, depending on how things are going. You just want to make sure that you're doing a slow, methodical approach to make sure that your body can keep up. So like I said, as you do this, you will start to recover better. Your metabolism will start to adapt to the higher calories, and things will start speeding along, and everything starts to click better. And I have seen it so many times where a person who started dieting goes through the dieting phase, then comes out with a reverse diet, they can roughly maintain, if not even lose in the beginning stages, and at the very worst, just gain a little bit back, but get their calories even higher than prior to even starting their dieting phase. But this only happens if you stay diligent to the plan. And what happens most of the time is we get to this point where we just feel like, I just can't deal with it anymore. I don't want to deal with it anymore. Things come up, you just don't have that focus anymore, and there's a lot of ups and downs, and then the body does not like that at all. The body craves consistency, and when there's a lot of ups and downs and you don't pay attention and you overeat and you come back and you're on and off again, then the process doesn't go so well. And the thing that's ironic about it is you probably are having a hard time sticking to the program because you just want to eat more food. But by eating more food early, you end up being able to eat less food later on. Because by overeating and kind of shooting up your body fat a little bit faster than you want to, and then maybe kind of trying to even that out a little bit and having lots of ups and downs, you can't keep stepping up your calories. Whereas if you stay diligent, even though in the beginning stages you might not be able to eat as much as you would like, if you stay diligent to that, over time, as the weeks progress, pretty soon your calories get higher and higher and higher and higher, and pretty soon you're eating way more than you would have been able to do because you stayed true to the plan. So I cannot stress enough how important it is to stay diligent to your plan and really stick to it in the beginning stages of a reverse diet after a dieting phase to make sure the process goes well. Now, I can't guarantee that you won't gain any weight. Chances are you're probably gaining a little bit, but you also have to understand that not all weight is created equal, right? In the beginning stages, your glycogen stores are low. You're going to start refilling glycogen. For every gram of glycogen that you store, you store 3 grams of water with that. So that's going to take part of it. But regardless, at this point, we're not trying to lose. We're not trying to push it to the next level. We're just trying to get your calories up and put you in a maintainable place if that's your goal. If you're not trying to build and you're just trying to maintain, we want to get your calories up into a more reasonable level so that you can enjoy your life a little bit more and enjoy some more food and put yourself in a position where it's much easier to maintain. Whereas if you keep overshooting every time you finish dieting, you just end up in this yo-yo dieting cycle and it becomes very difficult. So I hope that helps. I can't stress enough how important reverse dieting is after a dieting phase. This is a big part of why I think very few people can maintain weight loss. This is a big part of why literally 95% of people who lose weight cannot keep it off. Besides just a sustainability thing, most people don't reverse diet out. They either just stop and they try to maintain on those super low calories that they were dieting on, which just becomes to be too much of a grind, or they just go right back to their old eating habits and overeat like crazy and go through this binge restrict pattern that gets them nowhere. So any questions, please let me know, and I will talk to you later.
I'm addicted to the love that you're giving. Every minute, every day, I've been craving.